Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Currently we are looking up what is AWS and what are the features available. So what is AWS cloud? AWS has invested billions of dollars in IT resources that are distributed across the globe, and the use of those resources are shared among thousands upon thousands of AWS account holders. Now, although those resources are being shared among those account holders, the accounts themselves are completely isolated from each other at thus hypervisor level. You also have the options of your own dedicated resource if you wish. You as an account holder can have an on-demand delivery of IT resource on a pay-as-you-go pricing model. With no upfront cost, you only have to pay what you are using. So here, the more you use, the more you pay. The less you use, the less you have to pay. Don't use if you don't use, no, you don't pay for it. When you use it, you have to pay for. And we have a model like hourly base or minute base or the second base, and some services even provide billing by the millisecond. Now that provides some really good economic of scale, because the cost of infrastructure is shared across the globe upon thousand enterprise. That is a great, because you don't have to worry about the capital expenditure of your own infrastructure, and you don't have to worry about the infrastructure maintenance staff to support that infrastructure. Now the infrastructure is organized according to the range of different product types. If you want to use those IT resource for pure computing power, AWS can do for that for you. If you want to use AWS just to store the data, AWS can do for you as well. If you want to run the database as a service, if you want to run a related database, a NoSQL database, a graph database as a service, AWS can do for you, and they will do that on demand on a pay as you go pricing model. The AWS global infrastructure is massive, and it is divided into graphical, geographical, and those geographical regions are divided into separate availability zone. As you can see, there are a lot of regions distributed throughout a globe for to be located as you choose to your customer as a possible. But you may also want to minimize cost. For example, if you are locating in some region and some nearby locations is very cheaper, so that you can purchase, means you can deploy your systems over there. Like if you want to purchase any infrastructure, or you just wanted to take any databases, but your region is very costlier, but nearby location which is very comfortable for you and you are okay with the near location and it is very cheaper for hourly charge, then you can select that. So it is the server is like a server is located in many region. As you can see, there are Asia Pacific, there are some bunch of data centers, and for North America, the in North America, the this one data centers are more as compared to other. So it is depending on your requirement as well, and there are a number of factors to be considerations when selecting a region. Each region is divided up to at least two availability zones that are physically isolated from each other. This provide business continuity for your infrastructure. If you have it distributed across the multiple availability zones, if one availability zone goes down, the infrastructure in the other availability zone will continue to operate. The largest region is East North Vizina, has a 6 availability zone, and the availability zone are connected to each other throughout the high speed. And you can see the availability zone how it looks, and it is connected through a fiber optics network over a 100 of locations that are used in cloud front content delivery network. So popular content such as image and video and distribute that to each locations across the globe for high speed delivery to end user, no matter where they are located, and it will do that with very low latency. It is provide greatest network, greatest protections to your database, and it will ensure your data there is no any downtime, and it will give you some other flavors, like you can also monitor the data, how it is using and where the cost is accumulating and how I can reduce the cost. And AWS Management Console is a web-based infrastructure, and you can give some boundary. You can control the your database access, and without your permission, it will not allow others to connect to your database. And you can also able to visible where the cost is accumulating, and you can give some, you know. You can monitor your cost. You need to have an account to access, but once you have an account create, you can access it simply by clicking in my account menu and create a AWS website by selecting management console. It also AWS console from mobile app. Nowadays it is visible from mobile app. It is great for a tablet. You can also access AWS resource through a mini software development kit. This is allowing you now to create applications it have a and multiple software which is present in AWS console. And you just have to select what software you require. There are multiple templates inbuilt which will help you to develop your code, and there are multiple database which is inbuilt. You just have to select what you require. There are multiple infrastructure available. Just need to select the OS level which you require based on your cost and based on your infrastructure requirement, based on your entrepreneur requirement. What you require, you just have to select the database, you just have to select the software, select the OS, and you just need to select the storage level what you require. You no need to worry about a maintenance, whether the maintenance of patches activity and backup things. And in Amazon they have some white paper over there. You whatever issue you are facing, you are not able to troubleshoot, just have to drop the mail. That's it. So I believe you have enjoyed our session, and coming session we will discuss about how to create the instance, how to create the database, how to monitor my usage, and how to optimize my usage, and what all network control we can do while creating the database. And here we will show you how to take a backup, and from backup how to restore. So if you have any doubt regarding AWS before moving to next chapter, kindly put down on a comment box, and do not forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you so much. We will meet on next chapter with how to create an instance. Thank you so much.